Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. In this video, we're gonna see how to create this really nice paper collage effects that you can see in here using Adobe Photoshop. But before we're gonna do that, make sure to subscribe and comment and leave a like. Alright, so let's get to it. Alright, so let's go and open Photoshop, and I'll press Ctrl Command N to open a new document. And I will change the width to 3000, the height 2000, and the resolution let's put 300, and I'll press OK. Alright, now I will go to my folder, and I will open the texture that will be our background. Actually, this effect, it will be based on this image in here, as you can see. It has like pieces of paper that will work as a collage for us. So yeah, so this is will be our background. And let's actually delete this one and call this BG for background. All right, now I'm gonna create a new layer and I will name it image. And then I'll right click, convert it to smart object, right click again. It is content. And I will go and open the image in here in our smart object and make it bigger around here. Now I want actually to remove the background of this, so I will go to select and choose subject. And I won't be worried about our selection because it will be a collage and we'll apply a lot of filters. So yeah, I will keep it like that and I won't click on the layer mask. Now we'll close this and I will make sure to press yes to save. And there we go, we have our image. Now I'm gonna create a copy of this image. So I'm gonna press Ctrl Command J and I will rename the copy to color. And I will hide it from now by one click on this eye icon. And I will go back to our main image in here. And then I will go to filter and choose filter gallery. Now I'm gonna press Ctrl. Make it back to the default. The first filter that we're gonna actually add is in the sketch. So I will go and choose Hefton pattern. And you know, just go and experiment with this depending on the resolution. For example, if you use the same resolution as me, just keep the size between 1 to 5. For me, I will put 2. And the contrast is depend on the contrast of your image. For this one, I think 25 work very good. Yeah, and the pattern type, I have it set to dot, but you know, you have other options if you want. So we'll go and add another filter. And the second one, it would be tone edges. And again, go ahead and experiment with the number. For this image, I think 15 for all of them, it looks good, or I like how it looks like. So I will keep it like that. And then I will add another filter, or the last filter, it will be a frame grain. So I would go to artistic folder and choose thin grain. And again, feel free to experiment with this. I think I would keep it like this, 4 in the grain, 0 in the highlights. Maybe put down the intensity like 8 and I will press OK. All right, so that will be all for this image. Now I want to start to blend the texture in this image. To do that, we're gonna create another copy. To do so, we're gonna duplicate the background by pressing Ctrl Command J, and then we'll put it on top our image like that. And let's call this papers. And then, while I'm selecting this paper layer in here, I will go to the FX icon and choose blending options. Now, the only thing that we need to change in here is in the blend if. And it's in this layer. And also the color I have is set to gray because I only want to work in the gray tones. So I will take this white slider in here and I will move it to the left, as you can see. And the more I move it to the left, you can see that our image start to reveal itself because it's gray, as you can see. And also it actually work with the gray areas that we have in the texture. But if I zoom in, you can see that it's a little bit harsh and we don't want to do that. So we're gonna split it by pressing Alt or Option. We can split this slider. And now we will have a smooth transition from the white to black in here, as you can see, and the OP is okay. Now I know that it doesn't look that great, because especially in the shadows in here, but we can go ahead and fix that by applying a level adjustment, and I'm gonna clip it to the texture. Now we could actually change the texture to a smart object and apply the level directly to the texture, but I really like to have the level adjustment in here. It would be easier to access like this. So in the level, I'm gonna play with the midtones until I see something that I like. As you can see, now I starting to see all the features of the image and also the shadows in here, and that's exactly what I want. So yeah, I think I will keep this around here, and I always can go back and adjust this if I want. All right, I think it looks really nice. All right, now we're gonna add a little bit of color of this. Now we can leave it like this if you, that's what you want, but for me, I think I like to have a little bit of color on top. So to do that, we'll make the color layer visible, just like this, and then we'll go to image adjustment, and I will put like shadows and highlights, and I will keep everything set to the default, and I'll press OK. Next, I will go to filter and choose pixelate, and I will apply a color halftone. Now again, you can experiment with this. For this image, I will keep the radius set to 4, and I'll press OK. Now if I zoom in, you can see our halftone half colors, but I want it to be blended better with the image. So I'm just gonna change the color halftone blend mode alone by going to the settings that is in front of the color halftone. I will double click on it, and the blending mode option will open, and I will change it to soft light, and I hope it's okay. All right, now I want actually to apply the texture itself as a layer mask on this image. And to do that, I will select the background layer, and I will press Alt or Option. While I'm holding Alt or Option, I will one click on this eye icon, and this will make all the other layers invisible. Only the texture layer, or the background layer for this case, is visible. Now we'll go to select and choose all, and this will select the whole canvas. And then I will go to edit, and I will copy what I have in the canvas. Now we'll go to select again, deselect, and then I'm gonna press Alt or Option and hold it, and I will one click on this eye icon, and this will make all the other layer visible again. Now we'll select the color layer, and I will apply a layer mask, and then I'm gonna press Alt or Option and one click on the layer mask, and after that I will go to edit, and I will choose paste, and this will paste the texture image that we have in here. So I will go to select and deselect this, and then we'll one click outside of the layer mask, and we will have our texture in here applied on the color image in here, and that's what we want. All right, now I will select the layer mask, and I want to apply level adjustment, but only on the layer mask. So while I'm selecting this layer mask in here, I will go to image adjustment, and I will choose levels, or you can press Ctrl Command L to open this. And I will apply with the midtones until I see something interesting, and the black and white. So yeah, you can just keep playing with this until you are happy with what you have. Alright, I think I like how it looks like. You can see before and after. Now you can always put down the fill a little bit to have that halftone color appear more. For example, for me, I will put it around 75. And I think it looks really interesting like this. Alright, so the last thing I want to add is a little bit of adjustment. So I will go and add gradients map. I will open the gradients map, and let's change the black spot to maybe brownish color, a dark brown color like this. Alright, and I will change the white one to maybe blue or cyan. Yeah, so I would keep it like that for now, and just add another color in here, maybe more brown or maybe something like purple. Let's actually keep it like in the brown or the warm area in here. All right, so I'll keep it like that, and I will add one more color. This time let's go for something bluish. I like this, so I would keep it like that and maybe change the position a little bit. All right, so I would keep it like this for now, and then I'm gonna change the blender mode of this to soft light and put down the flow quite a bit, maybe 30%. Now we'll go and add a vibrance. Let's add a little bit of vibrance to this, maybe 40 or 35, and put down the saturation minus 20. And I think that's all what I'm going to do for this. So this is our effect. So I hope that you enjoy and you like this, and it was a little bit helpful for you. Don't forget to subscribe and comment, and you know where for more to come. And have a nice day. Thank you for watching.